Hello and welcome to Essential Cooking, where we help you make those difficult recipes just a little less complicated. I'm Rainey.
And I'm Melissa, and today we're going to show you how to make something delicious.
Hey guys, we're at the grocery store. I know I've never taken you to the grocery store, but this is my mom, and she's gonna show us how to cook a really yummy flounder dip.
La 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 la.
Yeah, we're getting some fish.
Flounder.
Ooh, flounder. Wild flounder fillets. Okay, guys. So my mom's gonna show us how to make stuffed flounder. It's really good, and I had someone request a fish dish, so here's your fish dish. You know who you are. So this is what you're gonna need. For the seasoning, you need half a teaspoon of black pepper, teaspoon of salt, teaspoon of garlic powder, a teaspoon of onion powder, a teaspoon of cayenne pepper if you like hot food, but if you don't, you can make that half a teaspoon or even a little less if you want with the cayenne pepper. And then you need 5 cans of crab meat. And there's 6 ounces. I don't think you can see that, but that's okay. I already said how much it is. And then you have 2/3 cup of mayonnaise. And there's the crab meat drained in a bowl. And here's the seasoning. We mixed it all up in there. And then you also need a cup of chopped green pepper and your flounder. And how many packs of flounder did we buy, Mom?
3.
We bought three packs, which were 12 ounce packs. So I think there was about 7 servings altogether. The way we're going to make this, and you take half of your seasoning and marinate your fish in it, and you also need a stick of butter and 1 egg scrambled, right? And 1 egg scrambled. Make sure to turn your oven on to 375 before you start putting everything together, so your oven will be nice and hot for you to put your fish in the oven. We're going to mix our crab meat with our cup of green pepper and our 2/3 cup of mayonnaise. And our 1 scrambled egg. And most of the seasoning, not all of it. There's probably still at least a tablespoon left.
Teaspoon.
That's a tablespoon. Maybe half a tablespoon.
Want to fight on this video?
We mix this all together, because that's going to be the filling that goes in between our fish. And now we're ready to put this dish together. So we're going to butter the pan, the bottom of the pan. And we're still going to use the butter for the fish too, so. So what you're going to do, lay 1 layer of fish on the bottom of the pan, and since we have 7 servings, we're laying 7 pieces down. And next we're going to put our filling on, and we're going to use all of it, So just spread it evenly between all the pieces that you're using for whatever, how many pieces you guys are making. And then next, you're going to take the rest of your seven pieces, well, our seven pieces, and lay it on top of each piece. And now she is taking 1.5 tablespoons of lemon juice and just kind of drizzling it on top of the fish. So we're putting 2 butter pats on each fish from our stick of butter that we had earlier. And remember that leftover seasoning? We're going to sprinkle that on top. Just a little bit over each piece. And then we're going to stick it in the oven right now. And we're going to bake it for 45 minutes.
Just to add a little color.
If you want. If you don't want to, you don't have to.
And then bake it 10 more minutes.
Treat for you. My mom likes to decorate food, so she wanted to decorate this for you. And she made a radish. That's a radish, right, Mom?
Beet.
Oh, it's a beet. My bad. A beet flower and some green onion curls. And we usually eat this with rice. But you can eat it with just like some vegetables on the side or whatever you want to make with it. But it is really good with rice. So there we are. Enjoy. Also, say bye, Mom. Thanks for cooking with us.
Bye. Enjoy and good luck.